Welcome everyone, it's Sylvia from Aussie Scrapper and I have a mini album I'll be working on today. I'm actually going to be working on the front cover and this project is a project for Aunty Vera Scrap and Craft. We are celebrating National Scrapbooking Day, but we are celebrating it all month long. So this is a project that I want to make for my godmother who is an avid gardener and I thought I would make her a special little mini album documenting my love for her and her love for gardening, and there's going to be all little secret messages for her, and I hope you join us on this wonderful journey. So I will be using this very old chipboard mini album that I've had in my stash. It's from Fab Scraps, and it's, well, let's just say it's been in my stash for a very long time, so that way I don't embarrass myself, hey? And I started by looking at what papers I was going to work with, and I'm going to be working on the front cover. It's a flip book, so it's going to flip up. Well, I've decided it's going to flip up. I guess if I wanted to, I could have flipped it to the side, but I decided to go the other way. So what I did was the first paper I picked was this gorgeous one, and I must say, before I forget, I'm using the Graphic 45 Garden Goddess Collection, and this paper that I'm working on now is actually called Garden Goddess, and it's beautiful. So I've got two of every sheet, so, and I really didn't want to cut into this, but I'm just going to be using the lovely green side, which had all that lovely beautiful green floral, and then I'm going to glue that onto the chipboard. I love that lady that I'm fussy cutting now. I'm just going around the whole little circle that she's in. And around it, it says, "My garden of flowers is also my garden of thoughts and dreams." And I just thought that is so appropriate for my godmother because she spends almost every day many, many hours in her garden. She's always weeding, planting, transplanting. And I hope one day I will be a good as gardener as her because I haven't really inherited that green thumb, but I've worked very hard to learn all about gardening and soil and everything, and she has taught me so much and I am so blessed. So you just saw me go through the Garden Goddess Patterns and Solids little booklet. It's got 16 sheets of 8 patterns and some solid papers that coordinate with the other lovely Garden Goddess collection. And I was going through it because I was trying to find the background for this little chipboard insert there, and that more or less pops up off the page. So it has to be like the focal point is what's going on in my mind. So I use just this lovely plain pink colour, and then I'm just going to stick my little lady there that's surrounded by her thoughts of gardening and her dreams and everything. And that's how I imagine my godmother when she's in the garden. She's thinking, and I know she's been through some very hard times, and that it's been her garden that has kept her sane and kept her alive and kept her from doing all sorts of silly things. So I'm really grateful that she has this wonderful passion and hobby that just keeps her going, especially when she's in her 80s. I mean, it's amazing. She's in her 80s and she still gardens and walks every day and even goes to the gym. My God, I hope I'm like her one day. As I mentioned, this is the front cover. So now I'm going to be using this little tag here that says, "Hello, beautiful." And that's what it is, because when my godmother opens this up, I wanted to read "Hello, beautiful," because it's, you know, it's my greeting to her, hello, and then she'll look through it and she'll see the pictures and the memories and everything else, because that's what we are celebrating in Auntie Vera Land for the next month. Do you remember? So it's all our memories that we're documenting, and I'm just documenting it in a mini album as a gift for someone, as I wanted to say, do you remember, you know, all these special times that her and I have shared. So that little tag there came from the Portrait of a Lady from Graphic 45, Tags and Pockets. I absolutely love how it's coming together. And then I'm going to be working on the flip side. And I chose this paper. It's called, is it Thoroughly Yours or Thoughtfully Yours? Anyway, it's one of the two. And I'm just going to start working, doing the same process as before, but on the flip side. I should add that all these products are from Aunty Vera's Scrap and Craft. I will leave a link in the description below, and these are all at reduced prices for the month of May as we celebrate National Scrapbooking Month, not Day, Month. This Graphic 45, I love their tags and pockets, this little section here. I'm in love with it. So I'm going to make one of the little pockets here, It's very easy. You just sort of fold down the sides and very easy to follow. You add your glue, and then I'm going to at some point in time leave a little note for her, or maybe a tag with a little note. I'm not sure. I haven't thought that far ahead, but I'm loving it. I knew I just had to use this little tag. I'll probably use all the little tags because I want to send lots of little hidden messages to her. One thing I didn't realize was that the little tag is also pink, so it really blended with the background. So all I did was I got one of the scrap pieces of paper that was left over and I matted it, and that made it help. Well, that helped to make it pop, and I really like how that worked out. And I love this gorgeous piece of paper. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fussy cut a few of the images, and that's going to help me do my second flip page. Lots of fussy cutting in this project, but I love how it turns out. So I'm just going to pick up one of the other papers, and these are all my little fussy cut images. They look so cute. And I must add that I've also inked the edges of all these images with some distress oxides in my favorite color, Vintage Photo. And look at that. I don't end up using them all, but I thought I would. And all I'm going to be doing now is working on my placement, seeing how I want this to go. And probably besides the fussy cutting, this is what took the longest, just trying to work out how my little images were all going to sit together. All the images are of this lady, and she's doing her gardening. And every time I look at these images, I just think of my godmother. So, you know, this is how I will always remember my godmother, in her garden. And I mean, I don't know how she does it, in her 80s, and she's still in her garden every day. Sometimes she needs to get help with the mulching, but in general she does everything. Here I'm using the sticker sheet that comes with the collection, and I just picked one of them that says Happiness Blossoms, because, well, you know, documenting my godmother, it's the garden is what makes her happy, and happiness always did blossom in her garden. That's where all my happy memories are. So then I needed to do something else. I couldn't work out what it was in that blank spot, so I decided to go with some stenciling. So I got out my Inca Gold. Originally I thought I was going to use a gold color, but then I ended up going with this green yellow color, and it was absolutely perfect. So the stencil is from Casercraft, and what's it called? The stencil is called Fancy Flourish from Casercraft. So I should add that I will be inking all around my border with some vintage photo distress oxides, and look how that's coming along. So now I'm going to be working on my little decorative piece, and I decided I was going to do some embossing, and I'm going to be using the embossing powder from Ranger in the gold color. I won't bore you with all the embossing. I'm just going to cut to the finished product. Look at all that beautiful shine. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to glue it onto that background page, or the front page, I should say, not the background. That's the front page there. And then I also glue down that little insert, and it's all done. So I hope you like the start of this mini album as I journey my memories with my godmother. And I look forward to seeing you all soon. So I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. I'm really trying to chase up subscribers. And also, if you like that, if you hit that thumbs button, that really, really helps my channel grow, or helps it grow, as well as everybody else's, not just mine. But if you're watching any YouTubers, just give them a thumbs up, a comment here and there. It really does help them. And we do a lot of work behind the scenes to get these videos to you. So we'd appreciate all that little help that you can give us. Thank you all so much. Until next time, take care of yourselves. Bye.